All right, we're here with Ryan Blaney. And first of all, Ryan, it is February in Chicago. I am wearing shorts and short sleeves, so you're probably a little better dressed. But welcome to Summertime Shy in February. Have you been to Navy Pier and experienced the full Chicago before?
First time at Navy Pier. I'm enjoying the views. I mean, I don't know if you can get a better view. I mean, you have the city, you have the open water. I mean, it's an amazing view. And I do get to spend a little time in Chicago, not as much as I'd like. You know, we come here for the race to kind of promote it. But I might come in a little early to really take in Chicago as a city because I do really enjoy coming here, and it has a lot to offer.
You need to. I see the little the pin for the Chicago race as well. I know last year didn't exactly go your way in the Chicago race. But what was it like racing in the Chicago streets?
Yeah, even though I had a terrible race, I really enjoyed myself. You know, myself and I'm sure everybody else, like, we didn't really know what to expect. The first time coming here, how's everything going to work? You know, what's the track going to be like? How rough is it going to be in these streets? And I thought it put on a really good show. I think every driver really enjoyed it once we got rolling. I know I did for sure. And even like your eye line is so different here than any other racetrack we go to, right? You're going down, you know, through the course and you're seeing the Chicago Museum, and then you're coming back towards the skyline. Like, it's just such a different view that we had behind the wheel, which is just something I never thought personally that we would ever experience. I never thought we would be coming here to race in any kind of city, let alone Chicago. And I think it's going to be even better this year.
I don't think Chicagoans ever thought that was going to be a possibility either, but it's a great relationship with NASCAR, and to see that coming back this summer will be awesome. Let's get to this bad boy behind me here, because I'm sure this has changed your life, being the NASCAR Cup Series winner. How has it changed your life?
Yeah, I mean, it's really great to have an accomplishment like that. You know, I grew up around the sport and I appreciated it, and I wanted to be like, you know, the guys I watched on TV winning championships, and I saw my dad race for a long time, and it's something that you work really hard for, right? And it's not only me. I mean, there's hundreds of other people that have hands in it within our organization at Team Penske, and it was really nice to share it with them. I think that was the most special part to me, was sharing something that is really hard to accomplish with them. And because you know how hard they work, how many hours that all the men and women put in, and to see it all happen and come true, like, that's a huge sense of pride that we can have in ourselves. So, and now it's, how do we do it again? You know, that's the tough part, is how do we make this happen again to where we can come back here next year? Now I have two of these things, so that's the new goal.
You always hear that in sports, no matter if it's football, baseball, racing, it's that getting to the mountaintop is tough, but staying there is the hardest part, right? So what does change this year, maybe with more of a target on your back?
Yeah, it is definitely hard to stay at the mountaintop, because I feel like, and you said it really well with, you know, other sports and things like that, it's the same, because, you know, you work so hard to get to that point, and now you feel like you do everything perfectly to get to that point, but you can't just do the same thing, right? You have to change up how you approach it and how you go about your season to accomplish it again, because everyone else is doing something different. Like, maybe what we did last year won't work this year. So how do you change yourself from what you thought was perfect in our team and myself? How do you evolve, right? Evolving is a huge thing in sports and racing and continuing to get better. So, and like you said, everyone you have a target on your back, right? Everyone wants what you have. So it's gonna be even tougher, but it's nice to know that we accomplished it once. So now at least we have an idea of how to get there. And now it's just the little things that we have to tweak to try to do it again.
You mentioned your dad. You know, what was it like growing up in a racing family?
A lot of weekends at the track, and that was our weekends. You know, I didn't really have weekends to go, you know, see my friends or go to other things other than racing. It just was my whole life. And but on the other side of it, I was fortunate to see motorsports at a young age and kind of understand how everything worked and operated, and had a father who was, you know, been through it all, you know, and I could always talk to him for advice. And that's the same thing. I'm 30 years old now, and it's the same way. You know, I still go to my dad for advice, you know, on the racing side especially, and he always is there to kind of help me out. So I was really lucky to have that. But yeah, a lot of weekends, a lot of I started when I was 8, so I've been doing it for a long time. And you know, you think it would get old, but I love this sport. I this is what I'm passionate about, and really lucky to have the opportunities that I've been given. And it's nice that we've been able to make the most out of them too.
We got to talk about what happened this weekend in Atlanta. 0.003 seconds, finishing in second place. Never a bad thing to finish in second, but when you're that close, what's the feeling in the moment?
Yeah, you know, I've been asked that, you know, since the Atlanta race. And while it's a bummer to run second, especially when it's that close, you can't really be too upset about it, because, you know, gosh, I mean, 0.03 of a second is 3 inches, you know, when you're going 190 miles an hour. So it's it was just nice to have a shot at it. It was cool to have a really spectacular finish. It's the third closest finish in NASCAR history. And to be three wide like that, I mean, three guys going for it was pretty special. So I hope all the fans really enjoyed that race. Not only the last lap was great, the whole race was fantastic. And I think that's just a preview for what you're going to see in this 2024 NASCAR season. But yeah, stinks to not win and run second. But at the end of the day, it's hard to be mad at losing by 3 inches.
Yeah, that's crazy that it comes down to just literally the inches. It is a game of inches, they say.
400 miles and it is decided by 3 inches is just crazy to me. Yeah.
Let's talk about the Netflix series that you're featured in as well. NASCAR Full Speed portrays you and the racers last season winning the playoffs, obviously. Do you feel like that is something that is going to help boost NASCAR, similar to what F1 got the treatment for Netflix as well, what it's done for the popularity of that sport?
Yeah, I thought the Netflix show was really, really beneficial for our sport and for the drivers in it, and it was honestly beneficial for, you know, the fans and people watching the sport, and maybe people who didn't know much about the sport, you know, of kind of giving them a little idea of, hey, this is what it's like in these grueling 10 weeks of the playoffs. It's stressful, you know, and for whatever reason, as a human race, we like watching people who are in stress, right? All these shows you have, you know, everyone tunes into that stuff. So it showed a really good idea of not only the racing you see on TV, but what goes on, you know, off the racetrack. All the prep work it takes going in, what these drivers' day-to-day lives are like, you know, and it was cool to kind of see all the different personalities. I learned stuff about other drivers that I didn't even know, and I race with the guys every week. So it was neat. Hopefully it comes back again. The fans really liked it. People really enjoyed it. I've met some people. We raced in LA at the Coliseum for the Clash earlier this year. And I met a handful of fans who watched the Netflix documentary and came out to their first race because they were curious and they really enjoyed it and they wanted to see what it was all about. And that's what we have to do. I mean, that's how you get new audiences. And, you know, the Chicago Street Race is a great example of new eyeballs on the sport. The hardest thing to do is, how do you draw somebody in, right? How do you convince somebody to fall in love with something that they know nothing about? And it's just showing them, right? Showing them how neat it can be and them experiencing it, you know, is a whole other thing. So it was great, and I'm happy people enjoyed it.
A couple quick ones before we let you go. You're recently engaged, I know. Congratulations.
Yeah,
wedding planning going all right? Is that more, is she taking the reins for that?
Yeah, it's. I'm learning very quickly of how much it goes into wedding planning. I mean, it's a wild ride. I've tried to give my fiance as much, like, all the reins. I'm like, you can do it. Yeah. Like, you got everything. But she is like, she includes me in everything, which I can't be upset about. You know, I want to be a part of everything. But some of the stuff, I'm like, you can do it. Just take care of it. But it's fun. We're really excited, you know, this winter to get married, and finding venues and figuring out all the little logistics and details is, it's almost like racing. Like, a lot goes into it. A lot of tiny little things mean a lot. Yeah. And we're excited for the day. I'm excited for the day. Like, all the planning and stuff, that's great. It can be stressful, but the day is gonna be, like, once we finally get to night before, the day of the wedding, like, that's when you're like, okay, we can finally not worry about planning, we can finally make this happen. So that's what I'm most excited about.
If you're still looking at venues, you know, offshore here at Navy Pier, I mean, I'm sure they'd love to have you.
I was looking at this place, you know, it's a pretty nice place. Good view, nice tent set up here. It's gonna be in December, so it's gonna be cold here, but we have an enclosure.
You never go bad.
Yeah, maybe old Navy Pier will help me out, you know, give me a discount, we'll see.
Finally, you're a big Star Wars buff, right?
Yeah.
You have a tattoo, is that correct?
Multiple.
Where did that love of Star Wars come from?
So I convinced my mother to take me to the Phantom Menace in 1999 when it came out. And my family wasn't really into Star Wars at all. I had an uncle that was kind of into it and showed me the originals when I was older. But like, I went, just where I grew up, I'm early 90s baby. So like, I went episode 1, 2, 3, and then I went to the originals.
Those are the first ones I saw too. Yeah, we're on the same age.
Yeah, so it was neat. I don't know. I think when I saw Phantom Menace, you know, as a kid, I was like 7 years old. So you're kind of figuring out what you like and you're creating your own little personality. And it just hooked me. And I've been a fan ever since into my adulthood, and enough to where I have tattoos of my favorite characters and collectibles and stuff like that. It's just really neat. And it's fun when you can have something like that as a kid that you enjoy, and it carries on into your adult life.
We can all be kids at heart. Who's your favorite character?
Exactly. It goes between, like, Darth Maul, I thought was the coolest guy ever because of Phantom Menace. But my couple tattoos, I have, like, a couple Darth and then a couple Luke tattoos. Yeah.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah.
I feel like Darth is never anyone's favorite character, but they just, you know, because his mystique is so present, yeah. Obviously, in the series.
Yeah, I mean, he's a terrifying character. Yeah. But and like as a kid, you see that guy, like, oh, he's just terrible person. But I think, and as an adult, I think you'd like him more. Like, oh, I can understand this guy. All right. So, he's just a mystique character that it grabs a lot of people.